In this training video film, we are going to talk about the troubles or the errors occurring in the SSDAC system. Although there are about 30 errors that may occur in the SSDAC system, but for better understanding, we will talk about only a few errors. First and foremost, let us see how an error can be calculated. The errors occurring in the system during the operation of SSDAC are encoded and are indicated by means of the 8 LED block present on the front panel of the MLB cards. All the LEDs are numbered as given below. DS1 to DS4 are designated as the least significant bits or the LSBs. And DS5 to DS8 are designated as the most significant bits or the MSBs. And each of these LEDs has a corresponding value assigned to it. For example, LED1 has a value of 1. LED2 has a value of 2. LED3 has a value of 4. LED4 has a value of 8. LED5 has a value of 10. LED6 has a value of 20. LED7 has a value of 40. And LED8 has a value of 80. The formula to calculate the error code is MSB plus LSB, which gives the error code. Now, if the LED numbers 1, 3, 5 and 6 blink, then the total values assigned to these LEDs will be added to get the error code. For example, 10 plus 20 plus 1 plus 4 gives 35. This means that error number 35 has occurred in the system. After having discussed how to calculate an error, let us see the different kinds of errors that occur in the SSDAC system. 1. Communication related errors. 2. Count related errors. 3. Relay readback related errors. 4. Miscellaneous errors. And 5. Reset box related errors. In communication related errors, the following errors can occur: link error, communication error, cyclic redundancy check error, that is the CRC error, end of block error is the EOB error. Link error. If the LEDs 5 and 6 are blinking, then error 30 has occurred as per the calculation explained to you before. In order to rectify the error, carry out the following checks. 1. Check the communication link between the unit. 2. Check whether the remote unit is power on or not. 3. Check for quad cable connection from location to location. 4. Check the power supply and its ripple content at the output of the battery charger. 5. Check the status of batteries. Check whether all the cells are properly connected or not. 6. Switch off the battery charger for 15 minutes and check the voltage drop. Communication error. If the LED number 7 is blinking, then error 40 has occurred in the system. Cyclic redundancy check error. If the LEDs 1 and 7 are blinking, then error 41 has occurred in the system. End of the block error. If the LEDs 2 and 7 are blinking, then error 42 has occurred in the system. All the above errors occur when communication between the two units is not proper. That is, packet information is corrupted, CRC of the packet does not match, or the end of the packet gets corrupted. If any of these errors occur in the system, carry out the following checks to rectify them. If quad cable is used as communication medium, Check the modem card parameters as shown in the chart. Check whether the remote unit is powered on or not. Check the power supply and its ripple content at the output of the battery charger. Check the status of the batteries. Check and ensure that all the cells are properly connected and working. Switch off the battery charger for 15 minutes and check the voltage drop. Remove the modem card and check the settings of the DIP switches. Operate the DIP switch so that any dust deposited may be removed and connection becomes proper. Repeat the same at both ends of the SSDAC if required. Check the surge voltage protection device. Remove the plug of surge voltage protection device and check if the system is working without surge voltage protection device. If the system becomes normal, replace the surge voltage protection device module. Check the value of the induced voltage in core to core of the quad pair used for communication. If induction is more than 5 to 10 volts, change the pair. Improve the earthing of the locations. Check the quad cable joints for any seepage in water or check whether the cable joints are proper or not. The armor of the quad cable can be earthed separately. In case the problem is not rectified, then carry out the following. Check that the correct type of cable is used for communication and no signaling cable is used. Check that the continuity of the armor of the quad cable is proper. Check and verify the following parameters. A. For attenuation loss, shall not be greater than 30 dB at the rate of 2 kHz. B. Near end crosstalk shall be better than 55 dB. C. Far end crosstalk shall be better than 55 dB. And D. Insulation resistance of the quad cable shall be greater than or equal to 10 mega ohms. Check and ensure that the proper pair of cable is used. Check and ensure that the unused pair of quad cable is cut in such a way that none of the conductors remain exposed. Check the pair in use are not made spiral. Check that no parallel wires or duplication of wires is used for modem connection. If the problem still persists, replace the modem card if required. In case the OFC channels are used as communication medium, 1. Check the parameters of the modem card. 2. Check these parameters are stable and ensure that there is no sudden variation in the signal values. 3. Check and ensure that proper channels used are lined up as specified in the checklist. Count-related errors. In count-related errors, the following errors can occur. Sequence error, count unequal error, count mismatch error, self count mismatch error, shunt error, internal shunt error, supervisory error, non-overlap pulses error, exit mismatch error, non-overlap pulses before overlap pulses error, sequence error. If the LEDs 5, 6 and 1 are blinking, then error 31 has occurred in the system. count unequal error. If the LEDs 5, 6, 4 and 1 are blinking, then error 39 has occurred in the system. If any of these two errors occur in the system, carry out the following check. 1. Check and verify the position of poles for mounting of axle detectors. 2. Check the voltages of the SCC1 and SCC2 cards. The voltage should be between 2 to 2.5 volt DC. If the problem still persists, replace the MLB cards with spare cards having software version S006 installed. Count mismatch error. If the LEDs 1, 3, 5 and 6 are blinking, error 35 has occurred in the system. In order to rectify the error, carry out the following checks. Check the output voltages of the SCC1 and SCC2 cards. The voltage should be between 2 to 2.5 volt DC. Check the resistance of the TX coil and RX coil. The resistance of the TX coil should be less than 1 ohm. The resistance of the RX coil should be between 2 to 3 ohms. Check the length of the TP circuit. Its minimum length should be 33 meters. In case of amplitude type modulation only, check the voltages of the TP relays. Check the presence of the reverse bias diodes on coil of repeater relays TPR, VPR and PPR. Self-count mismatch error. If the LEDs 5, 6 and 2 are blinking, then error 32 has occurred in the system. This error occurs when software detects the counts of the MLB cards in the local unit. In order to rectify the error, carry out the following checks. First, check and ensure that the software version S006 is installed in both the MLB cards. Second, if it persists, replace the MLB cards with spare cards having software version S006 installed in them. Shunt error. If the LEDs 5, 6, 3 and 2 are blinking, then error 36 has occurred in the system. This error is displayed when the train makes rocking movement on axle detectors without proper direction influencing only external detector twice without affecting the internal detector. Internal shunt error. If the LEDs 5, 6 and 4 are blinking, then error 38 has occurred in the system. This error is displayed when train makes rocking movement on axle detectors without proper direction influencing both the axle detectors and the internal detector is influenced twice. Both these errors can be resolved by applying reset from the Essence Reset box. Supervisory error. If the LEDs 5, 6, 3, 2 and 1 are blinking, then error 37 has occurred in the system. This error is generated if signals of any of the axle detectors become low. In order to rectify the error, carry out the following checks. 1. Check the voltages and frequencies of the transmitter and the receiver coils. 2. Check the voltages of SCC1 and SCC2 cards. Adjust or replace if any of the above readings are not found okay. If problem still persists, replace the MLB cards. Non-overlap pulses error. If the LEDs 7 and 3 are blinking, then error 44 has occurred in the system. This error occurs if the wheel is moved in such a way that non-overlap pulses are generated by the system in forward direction beyond permissible limits. If the error is generated frequently, carry out the following checks. Ensure that the software version S006 is installed. Ensure that the axle detectors are not installed on curved lines or worn-out rails. Check and ensure that the position of the axle detectors is correct. Check for failure by moving different motor trolley, perforated push trolley, dip lorry, etc. Exit mismatch error. If the LEDs 2, 3 and 7 are blinking, then error 46 has occurred in the system. This error is displayed when the overlap pulses are generated at the entry end and non-overlap pulses are generated at the exit end or vice versa. Non-overlap pulses before overlap pulses error. If the LEDs 4 and 7 are blinking, then error 48 has occurred in the system. In order to rectify the error, carry out the following checks. 1. Check the movement of non-standard push trolley in the sections where phase-type axle detection systems are installed. 2. Connect the track circuit if it is available in case movements of trolleys are unavoidable. And 3. Check the position of the axle detectors and verify it by moving different type of trolleys. Relay readback related errors. In relay readback related errors, relay readback error can occur. Relay readback error. If the LEDs 5, 7 and 2 are blinking, then error 52 has occurred in the system. Relay readback error. If the LEDs 5, 7, 1 and 2 are blinking, then error 53 has occurred in the system when the section is in occupied state. In order to rectify the error, carry out the following checks. 1. Check and ensure that the VR and PR relays are properly connected in the VR box and secured with the retaining clip or not. 2. Check the resistance of the pickup contacts of the VR relay and replace the relay if the resistance is found high. 3. Check the coupler used for readback for any dry soldering or breakage. 4. Check and ensure the presence of reverse bias diodes in VR, PR, VPR and PPR relays. And 5. If problem persists, replace the relay driver card and the MLB card. Now let us talk about some other errors which may occur in the SSBAC system. Secondary CPU error. Secondary CPU fail error. Watchdog reset error. Remote error. Secondary CPU. If the LEDs 7, 6 and 1 are blinking, then error 61 has occurred in the system. Cards MLB 1 and MLB 2 share the state information with each other at regular intervals. If MLB 1 card is in different state from that of MLB 2 card or vice versa, then error 61 appears. If error 61 appears on both MLB cards, then it can be corrected by applying reset from the Essence Reset panel. But if the error 61 appears only on one MLB card and the adjacent MLB card shows some other error code, then the rectifications to be followed will be that of the error code on the adjacent MLB card. For example, if error 61 appears on one MLB card and on the adjacent MLB card, error 41 appears, then carry out the checks for error 41. secondary CPU fail. If the LEDs 7, 6 and 2 are blinking, then error 62 has occurred in the system. This error is generated if any of the CPU fails to respond with its adjacent CPU due to failure of any components. This means that the adjacent MLB card is faulty. Replace the adjacent MLB card with spare card. Watchdog reset error. If the LEDs number 6, 7, 2 and 3 are blinking, then error 66 has occurred in the system. This error is generated when system detects the power supply interruptions, which results in interruptions of DC voltages by DC to DC converter. To rectify this error, carry out the following checks. 1. Check for the power supply and its ripple content at the output of the battery charger or the IPS module. Check the status of the batteries and ensure that all the cells are properly connected and are working. 3. Clean the battery terminals of each battery cell if required. 4. Check the resistance of the battery cells and replace the cell if resistance is found high. 5. Check and verify the presence of glitch in 24 volt DC output when the battery charger is switched to manual mode or in case of change over of the AT supply. Check that no other load is connected to the battery charger or the IPS other than the axle counter. Remote error. If the LED number 8 is blinking, then error 80 has occurred in the system. This error code is displayed if any error is detected in the remote unit. It means that the local unit is okay. Check the errors in the remote unit and rectify them. Reset box related errors. Now we will talk about some errors which may occur in the reset box of the SSDAC system. No data available on the reset box display. No display or corrupted display occurs on reset box. If no data is available on reset box display, carry out the following checks. 1. Check the modem connections on the reset box. And 2. Check the voltages of modem on the reset box. If no display or corrupted display occurs on the reset box, carry out the following checks. 1. Check the modem connections and voltages of the reset box. 2. Apply reset to the display.